I'm going shopping today. I'm not using cash or a credit card. I'm using my Android phone. Mobile payments aren't a new thing. Google Wallet's been around for a while, and Apple Pay has helped make NFC-based mobile payments a little more mainstream. But now there's two new players vying for space on your home screen, Android Pay and Samsung Pay. Android Pay is essentially Google Wallet rebranded. It uses the existing NFC chip that's in your phone, just like Google Wallet did, except now the app takes things like Costco cards. I'm inside one of my favorite bookstores, Green Apple Books, here in San Francisco, and I thought this would be a great place to try out using Android Pay to buy some early Christmas presents.
Hi.
Hello, I'd like to buy traditional media, please.
I can help you out. So it's $68.45.
Okay.
Ooh, thank you so much.
So I just realized I accidentally bought a book I already own. So now I have to return it.
I now need to return a book because I realize I already own all of David Sedaris' books.
This is a common mistake. Don't worry.
Oh, there we go.
All right.
Thank you. So there's one caveat to using Android Pay. NFC isn't accepted everywhere, so that local family-owned business down the street or the bodega nearby your apartment might not take NFC, and that's where Samsung Pay comes in. Samsung Pay uses MST, a technology it acquired earlier this year when it bought LoopPay. MST uses a magnetic coil on the back of the device which emulates a physical card, so you can use it at almost any retailer that takes credit cards. However, Samsung Pay only works with 4 Samsung devices, which makes it pretty limited.
Are you all set?
Yes.
Awesome.
Okay, now I have to update this app. Oh no, a software update? Are you kidding me? Can't do this right now. I have to do a software update now. Yeah.
The Galaxy S6 Edge Plus I'm using decided it was time for a software update right in the middle of a transaction. Thanks for nothing, AT&T. I put the Galaxy S6 Edge Plus back in my purse to update and whipped out my regular GS6 Edge to pay with Android Pay instead.
I'm gonna get this dry shampoo to refresh my hair. Okay, I'm gonna try paying with this Samsung Pay that I have. Here, you wanna try it? So, this is incredibly awkward, but we're gonna do this. I have to put this dry shampoo back on the shelf. I'm sorry.
Okay.
This is totally awkward. I just used Samsung Pay to try and buy a bottle of dry shampoo here at Blow, the blow dry bar in the marina. Unfortunately, the transaction didn't go through at all. The MST was working, the app was working, the magnetics were magnetizing, but for some reason, the transaction would just not go through. So I've left Blow and I am without dry shampoo.
Now it's time to drown my sorrows in a box of cream puffs and give Samsung Pay another try.
Well, I've had a fun shopping day. I came home with a ton of new things. I got to start at my favorite bookstore and went on to my favorite clothing boutique. And then I found a couple places along the way. Unfortunately, I also hit a couple snags on the way. At Ambiance, my phone decided it wanted to do a software update in the middle of the transaction, and then when I got to Blow, my phone did not work with their credit card terminal. At the beginning of my shopping journey, I thought that I would have more problems paying with Android Pay, but it turns out that Samsung Pay is the one I had the most snafus with. Android Pay uses NFC, so I imagine the merchants that accept it have already been briefed on the technology and know what to do when something goes awry. Most people don't even know that their businesses take Samsung Pay, so when something goes wrong, who do they turn to? It's up to Samsung to educate those merchants in order for Samsung Pay to become as ubiquitous as it's marketed as. For now, I'm gonna keep taking my wallet with me because I'm still not 100% sold on paying with my phone.